Hello, sustainable growers. Today we're going to talk about filtration in aquaponics. So you probably know that I'm specialized in small-scale growbed aquaponics, such as the ones I have behind me. So they are composed of mainly a fish tank and a growbed on top of it. So for the small-scale setup, most of the time we don't use any filtration, any specific filtration. So we will see today that there are two types of filtration. There is the mechanical filtration and the biological filtration. We're going to talk about it. But when we design a classic growbed aquaponic setup for a backyard, so a small scale setup, everything is ensured by the growbed. Because in the growbed we got some bacteria, but we got also a lot of rocks, a lot of media. And this media is going to basically act as a mechanical filter and as a biological filter. So by mechanical filter, we mean basically cleaning the water, retaining or filtering all the big particles of organic matters. So you know that when your fish are into the water, you feed them, they're going to eat this food, the fish food, the fish pellets, and they're going to also release some into the water. So what we use in aquaponics mostly for the nitrogen cycle is the ammonia. So the fish is going to release some ammonia into the water by the gills when he breathes, by the pee when he pees into the water, and also by the poo. So there are three ways that the fish is going to release the ammonia. Also, when he dies, his body is going to break down as well, and he's going to release some ammonia into the water. But this point is not very important in aquaponics, because what we want when a fish dies, we want to get rid of it, remove it from the tanks. So what we need to focus on is the ammonia that is produced by the fish, released by the fish through the gills, through the pee and the poo. So those three types of ammonia, you got two of them, the pee and the gills, they are released into the water. So they are not solids. You can't really touch them. They are diluted into the water and they go directly into the growbed, where they are transformed, thanks to the bacteria, into some food for the plant. So obviously it starts with ammonia, and then it produces some nitrates and then some nitrates, and the nitrates are the source of fertilizer for the plant. Now for the poo, for the fish poo, it's a bit different. The fish poo is going to go through the pump. A part of it is going to be broken down and basically diluted into the water in very, very thin particles, but some big particles are going to be also present into the growbed, and those big particles, they're going to form a big quantity of organic matters, and sometimes they're going to be trapped in the growbed for a while. If you got a good ecosystem, some animals are going to break it down and they're going to help to dilute it into the water, but sometimes it's going to clog also the media. So depending on the type of media you have and the size of the media, for example, here we are working with scoria 7 millimeter. So scoria is a volcanic rock, and therefore it's got some very, very tiny holes inside. And if you work with clay balls as well, that's the same thing. They are porous, but the holes are very small. If you release big particles of organic matter, so a lot of fish poo, with the time, with a few years, it may clog the system. So when the system clog, you got some area of your media that don't have access to the oxygen anymore, because there are so many basically mud organic matters around this media that it doesn't have any access to the oxygen of the water or of the atmosphere. So in this case, it turns anaerobic. You got a fermentation, and then it can generate some problems in your aquaponic setup. So in aquaponics, what we want is to keep all the biomass and all the media in aerobic conditions. And to maintain those aerobic conditions, obviously we got a bell siphon that is going to allow us to work with a flood and drain system. But also, we will have to maintain our growbed every 2 years or 3 years or 5 years, depending on the type of organic matters you have. We will have to clean the media. So we'll have to move the media and making sure that all those big organic matters that are present into the media, and all the roots of the vegetables and all those fins that can plug basically the system. We're going to move everything, and we're going to allow all those particles to be flushed away from the system. So it's going to allow us to stay in aerobic conditions. So you have to do this every, you know, as I said, every few years, depending on your system, on the way you feed your fish, on the temperature, on a lot of things. Now, if you use a mechanical filtration is going to help you to retain those big particles before they enter the grow bed. So we got different types of mechanical filters. In aquaculture, they are very much used. Some of them are passive and some of them require some power. So today I want to focus on the passive mechanical filters. They are very interesting because obviously they don't cost any money. They are free. You just have to build it and then you install it, and it doesn't require any specific source of energy. And they can basically retain all those big organic matters, which means that only the clean water is going to go through your grow bed and through your system. All the fish poo that are big particles, they're going to be captured into this mechanical filter. In the mechanical filters, the two that are very much used in aquaponics at the moment, they are the Swire filter and the radial filter. So there are two types of filters. The Swire filter basically works with the centrifugal force.
So here we got the sketch of a Swire filter. So the Swire filter is going to work with the rotation of the water. So the idea is to have the water coming into a drum thanks to a pipe. So here you got the pipe number one. So the water is coming into this pipe, and here you see there is an elbow at the end of the pipe. So here the water is turning. Once it's into the pipe, the water is turning. And all the particles, they're going to stay because of the centrifugation. They're going to stay on the extremity of the drum, basically close to the walls of the drum. And then they're going to fall down because they are heavy, and they're going to sit on the bottom of the tank. So all the particles are going to fall down, and you're going to find them here, while the clear water only is going to be able to access to the extremity of the pipe number two. It's going to fall into the pipe number two, and it's going to go to the next step. So this is how a Swire filter works. So you can see that basically into this drum, you're going to capture all the solids on the bottom, and the clean water is going to come through and is going to go to the next stage. Here we got the same thing, but it's a view from the top. So you can see that the water is coming from the pipe number one, and here, hop, it rotates. And therefore, all the particles are going to settle down, and they're going to touch the side of this Swire filter. So the side of the drum, basically, the walls, and they're going to slowly fall down, and they're going to settle down, while the water, the clear water, is going to stay in the middle, and it's going to fall on the surface inside the pipe number two. So here we capture all the solids. So that's how a Swire filter works. And that's basically one of the most simple filters to build if you want to build it by yourself.
The radial filter works in a different way, but it works basically with the speed of the water. We break the speed of the water and it helps all the particles to settle down. So same thing, we got a drum, and all the particles are going to settle on the bottom of the drum, and the clear water is going to be able to go to stage two.
So here you can see what we call a radial filter. So this filter is going to have the same purpose as the Swire filter. So both of them, they are what we call mechanic filter. So they're going to mechanically, or basically physically, retain the particles. So basically they work with the weight of the particles. So the idea is that the particles are heavier than the water, And if you put them in a place where there is no much movement, no much water movement, they're going to settle down. So here the idea is to have the water that is coming through the pipe number one, basically, inside the drum, and then it comes to almost the surface. And here then the water is going into a pipe that is just a little bit larger than the incoming water, the incoming pipe. It's like probably three times the size of the pipe that that is taken to come. So basically here now the water is falling down, but the speed of the water is slightly decreased, right? Because there is more surface. So you know that the speed of the water, there is a constant, like it means that the water flow is equal to the speed multiplied by the section. So the section of the pipe, here you see that the section of the pipe is way larger than the section of the pipe inside. So basically when the water comes here, up, it starts to decrease in terms of speed. And when the water is out of this pipe here, it arrives into this big tank, the speed completely decreases because the section of the tank now is huge, right? So the water flow here is very, very low, right? The water flow is always the same, right? Inside the thing, the water coming is always the same. So the water going to this pipe is always the same. But what I mean here is that the water flow is constant, but the speed is going to decrease dramatically here, because the section is huge. If you compare this section here to the section there and to the section here, there is a big difference. So here, the speed of the water is almost stopping, and therefore all the particles can just settle down slowly to the very bottom of the tank, while the water, the clear water, is going to raise very slowly to the surface of this drum, and therefore fall down into the pipe number two and go to the next stage. So you see the difference. The Swire filter is working with rotation of water. Here it's working just only with the gravity and with the sections of the pipes. So the idea here is really to stop the speed of the water. While into the Swire filter, we still try to maintain a nice rotation. Here we want to have the water very, very quiet. Now this radial filter is very efficient as well, but you need to have this pipe here. So most of the time we fix this pipe to the lid, or we put a piece of metal or something here on the top to basically maintain this larger pipe above the water. So I recommend both of those systems. They are really, really good. They are both very useful to retain the particles, to avoid to have some organic matters that fall into your grow bed.
So now, why is it so important to have those types of filters in aquaponics? Well, it's very interesting, I think, because first, it's going to allow you to clean your grow bed a bit less. You know, you may have to clean your grow bed, maybe if normally you would have to clean it every 2 years, maybe you would be able to clean it every 3 or 4 years if you have a biological mechanical filter. Also, all those bacteria that are living in the grow bed, you know, with time they form what we call a biofilm, which is a good film, but then the biofilm can become very thick and it can also clog the media. So even if you got a good mechanical filtration, it's not going to avoid the maintenance of the grow bed. So sometimes you will have to move your grow bed, move the media, and basically clean the media. But the filter, the mechanical filter, is going to basically capture all the solids, and therefore it's going to minimize the quantity of ammonia that is going to be generated for the system. So it can have an advantage is if you want to put a bit more fish in your system. By putting a filter, you basically minimize the quantity of ammonia that is going to be present in the setup, and therefore you will be able to capture them and to use them for a classic garden. So you will be able to siphon or to collect the particles that are on the bottom with this drum, and you will be able to use it as a fertilizer for your classic garden. So it's going to be an excellent fertilizer. So you don't lose it, you don't waste anything, but in the same time, you're going to maintain a lower concentration of ammonia and nitrate in your aquaponic setup. So if, for example, you have a lot of fish and not enough growbed, having a filter is going to help you in this way. It's going to decrease the quantity of nitrogen in your setup. So it's a really good point. Now there is another type of filtration. It's called the biological filter. So the biological filtration is basically exactly what we are doing in the growbed. It's giving a good environment for some bacteria to grow and basically to transform the ammonia in nitrite and the nitrite in nitrate. So by doing so, we're going to basically add a media into a big drum with a lot of movement thanks to some aeration. So we need an air pump here, and the air pump is going to blow some air on the bottom of this drum. And while the air is going to the surface, it's going to create a movement. So all the pearls, all the media that is inside this drum is going to be in movement all the time. So all the bacteria that are living here, they are in full aerobic conditions. It's full of air, plenty of air. And also, because there is such a movement, the pearls of media are always shocked one against each other. So if there is a biofilm of bacteria that is growing on the media, once it reaches a certain size, up it's basically with the shock, it's disconnected and it flows away. So this type of biological filter doesn't need any specific maintenance. So that's a really, really interesting point. So today with this video, I really wanted to present you all the different types of filtration that you can have. I mean, the general one, so mechanical and biological. And now if you want to go further and if you want to build your own soil filter, I designed a training, a real training to help you to build your Swire filter. So you can access this completely free training and you don't even have to put your email. You just follow the link below. You don't have to do anything really. I'm not capturing any emails here. I just want to help you to build your filter. So if you build this filter, again, it's going to help you to be a bit more comfortable if you want to put a bit more fish in your setup, and to manage a bit better the quantity of ammonia, nitrogen that you have in your aquaponic setup. And also it will allow you to capture the solids for your classic garden. So you will have a source of fertilizer for your classic garden. And finally, it's going to allow you as well to have a bit less maintenance in your growbed. So you don't have to clean the growbed every 2 or 5 years. It's going to extend the frequency of the maintenance in the growbed. So don't forget, just click on the link in this video and you will have access to this free training. Again, you don't have to put your email, so it's just a click, and then it's a step-by-step and you just follow it and you will be able to build your own Swire filter at home. So obviously with this video, you still have access to the 6-step process to build your own aquaponic setup, which is also a free training that you can have access by the description of this video. If you think this video was interesting, don't forget to give me a like. And if you want more tips of this type, just subscribe to the channel. It's going to help the Melbourne aquaponics community to rank in YouTube. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon. And I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.